Inorganic coating. Inorganic coatings are generally chemical conversion coatings. A surface layer of a metal is easily converted into a compound, that is either by phosphate or by its oxide when it is treated with the phosphoric acid or other suitable chemical reactions respectively, which forms a barrier between the underlying metal surface and the corrosion environment. The chemical conversion coatings are different from other types of coatings in the sense that they are the integral part of the metal itself. This type of coatings are formed on the metal surface by chemical dip or spray or by electrolytic methods. In addition to the corrosion resistance, these type of coatings are also provide increased electrical insulation and enhance adherence for paints and other similar organic coatings. Now we will discuss anodizing or anodizing of aluminum metals. This method is preferred for only for non-ferrous metals like aluminum, zinc, magnesium, chromium, titanium, etc. It is extensively done on aluminum and its alloys. What is anodizing? In this method, we are developing an oxide layer on the surface by induced oxidation in an oxidizing environment, making the object anode and passing the current. The most commonly used bars are chromic acid, sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, oxalic acid, or mixture of these. Lead is generally used as a cathode. The anodic oxide film formed on aluminum in the bath, these materials tends to be porous and provides good adherence for paints and dyes. Anodizing of aluminum. So these are the steps involved in the anodizing of aluminum. It can be carried out by making it anode in an electrolytic bath containing a suitable acid like chromic acid or phosphoric acid or oxalic acid at 40 degrees centigrade. A plate of lead or stainless steel is made as cathode. When current of moderate density is passed, oxygen liberated at the anode combines with anode material to form an oxide, which takes in the form of a thick film Al2O3 deposits on the surface of object. These are the reaction taking place during the anodizing process. At anode, aluminum undergoes oxidation. At cathode, there is a liberation of hydrogen gas. The final reaction is as it is. Aluminum get converted to aluminum oxide. The thickness of the deposit is controlled by adjusting the current and the bath solution. The coating still is slightly porous and it is sealed by dipping in hot water. Al2O3 gets hydrated to Al2O3 into H2O, which occupies more volume and hence protects the metal from the corrosion. Application wise, these anodized articles are used for office partition, hardware, lobbies, escalators, elevators and window frames, etc. Phosphating. Phosphate coatings are very important, especially in automobile industries. Automobile bodies are the best known example for phosphating. Here the treatment provides a good base for the paint and also provides some time before rusting occurs if the finish is damaged. What is phosphating? Basically, a development of a phosphate layer on the surface by the reaction of metal with dilute phosphoric acid solution is called phosphating. The phosphating solution usually contains essential requirements like free phosphoric acid. It reacts with the metal surface. Metal phosphates such as zinc, manganese, which increase the adherence and decrease the porosity of the coatings. In order to speed up the reaction, we are going to add accelerators such as nitrites, chromates, peroxides. They will help to complete the reaction as early as possible. This process is carried out in a pH around 1.8 to 3.0 and a temperature of 35 to 40 degrees centigrade. This process involves the following steps. In the first step, the metal undergoes oxidation, that is, dissolution of the metal takes place. In the next step, these metal ions will combine with the phosphate ions to form metal phosphates. In the last stage, these metal phosphates are deposited over a metal which acts as a barrier between the metal and the environment. The reaction when iron takes place, when iron is used as a metal, this is the reaction taking place. Iron react with the phosphoric acid to form respective phosphates along with the liberation of hydrogen. Therefore, we can say that during phosphating, converting the surface metal atom into their phosphates by chemical or electrochemical reaction is called phosphating. It is this phosphating is essential is used for the production of metal parts which cannot be painted or readily plated, such as nuts, bolts, or moving parts of the machinery. One important application is the phosphating of galvanized iron, which is otherwise difficult to paint satisfactorily.